Bonjour, de Nouméa, et donc de la Nouvelle-Calédonie. Hey guys, and greetings from Nouméa and from New Caledonia. I just want to give you a quick recap of my first Olympic distance non-drafting race. It was actually quite different from my regular ITU drafting races, and I just want to go through real quick. There were a few things that I actually enjoyed in that new format, and also a few things that, well, I didn't. So let's go through it. First, the swim start. First time I actually started in a swim start with several rows of athletes, which means that all the age group athletes were right behind us. And as I'm not really used to that, and there was no on your marks at all, there was just the gun. And I wasn't prepared for that. And then all of a sudden, all the age groupers just rolled over me, and I was in the middle of the age group pack and had no chance of just swimming ahead. So I had to fight my way out of the pack to the front, which already took a lot of energy out of me. But then it wasn't too bad because it didn't take too long, maybe just 200-300 meters. And then I was actually in the front with the leaders of the race, but from there on, nothing really happened. And all the favorites got out of the water together. So we could basically have just left the swim because it didn't make any difference. So there were three other guys that were pretty good, and they were just behind me on the swim exit. Transition, as always, it's the same as on the short distance. But then came the bike, and that was, of course, the main difference to my regular racing. The thing I actually enjoyed a little bit was that right from the beginning, you could go your own pace on the bike, and it was not all or nothing. Either you get the front peg or you don't, and either you win or you lose. So that was a lot less stressful than on the ITU circuit. But then I was pretty much overtaken by those three guys right away. And as those three guys all had time trial bikes and I didn't, there was basically no chance of holding on to them. So I rode on my own right from the beginning. Basically, I did hold on to the power my coach gave me, and in the end I averaged a power of 320 watts, and with that I had a total time of 1 hour and 25 seconds for the 40k on my road bike. So I just gotta explain real quick, the time trial bikes have a different geometry, so you can basically lie on the bike. And as you can see, you have those long aero bars. So you basically lie on the handlebars and the saddle, as opposed to my road bike, where you usually sit on much more upright. The only thing I could do was attach one of those short ITU racing aero bars, but they're not supposed to go further to the front than the brake levers. So in that configuration, you're pretty much crouched together on your bike. But yeah, as I don't have a TT bike, there was nothing to do. I couldn't buy a TT bike just for the one race, and I usually don't need it, so there was that. And I just had to take that huge disadvantage and live with it and just gave it my all, and that's what I did. So altogether, I lost 3 minutes on the bike to those other three guys. They pretty much formed a pack in the front, and as the drafting box was only 5 meters in that race, you could pretty much say that they formed a front pack. So coming into T2 with 3 minutes down, you're usually out of the race. And as well, in that race, I couldn't expect to catch any of those guys in the front. But I just started to run fast and see what's happening. And actually, there was one guy who's coming from the middle distance and long distance races that I was actually able to catch right on the end of the run. I think it was just 1K to the finish. So that was pretty tight, but I made it. And so in the end, I did end up third place. So it didn't help me that I had the fastest swim and the fastest run, as I just lost too much on the bike. And yeah, there was no chance with a road bike against those guys on a TT bike, because they're just too good. I guess I would have had a chance if I had a TT bike on my own, but yeah, no excuses. So now, what's the difference between non-drafting and drafting races? Well, On the one hand, you basically run below the limit all the time in the non-drafting races, like just below the limit or maybe on the limit, as opposed to the non-drafting races where you have times where you actually run a lot below your limit because you're in a pack and like you're drafting or in the swim, there's guys around you and you can't do anything. But then there's other times where you're just way over your limit because you have to catch up to a group or on the start of the swim, you have to smash it all out because there's no other way. It's way smoother, the non-drafting race, which also means that your legs feel a little bit different, I would say. And if I had to draw an image, I would say the non-drafting race felt a little bit like someone always hitting you, like every second, hitting you with two fingers on your neck, as opposed to the drafting races, in the ITU races. It feels like someone is punching you right in the face every 10 seconds. So on the non-drafting, you basically have that constant pain, which is not too bad. But then on the drafting races, you just get smacked really hard every other second. So when I got onto the run in the non-drafting race, it pretty much felt like I was racing in the same zone all the time. So that's like I didn't have a lot of variation, and that made the legs a little more tired, but not aching too much. And because of that, staying in the same zone all the time and not exceeding your limit too much, there's also much less chance of actually like really exploding on the run. Whereas on the ITU races, there's always guys that just go way over the limit on the bike, or have to go way over the limit on the bike, and then on the run, just go maybe 5 minutes slower than their PB. And then also running all alone, that was pretty hard for me because usually you have guys around you that you dismount with together on the bike. Yeah, well, now I was 3 minutes down, so I had no one around me, and that was pretty tough because I usually like holding on to some guys or a bunch and then outsprinting them in the end. Usually like that kind of guy. But yeah, on that race, I was running all alone for the full 10K. Only after 9K, I overtook the one guy as I already ran down 3 minutes on him on 9K. That wasn't a real battle there. So in conclusion, it's a lot less stressful to race non-drafting races because you don't have that constant stress to make it into a bunch or not lose the bunch or anything. That's the benefit of racing on your own. You can pretty much hold on to exactly the wattage you have to hold on, and you know you can. So there's a lot less risk, and that's also probably why the results in non-drafting races are much more constant. So you won't get guys finishing in first place in the one race and then get 20th in the next race, because it's much more about their own performance. While on the ITU races, you have a lot more variation in results because it just depends on if you make a pack or if your pack is just way too fast for you and you explode afterwards. You can't really predict on how people are going to finish in each particular race. But yeah, I guess that won't be my last non-drafting race, and there's still things to learn. And of course, the biggest thing would be to get a TT bike and actually not have that huge disadvantage. But yeah, maybe next time for that. So what's your opinion? How do drafting and non-drafting races differ? And what is maybe better, or what do you like more? Make sure to leave a comment down in the comment section. And if you haven't done already, make sure to subscribe to my channel, and you'll get all the new videos first. So thanks for watching, and see you next time, guys. I'm just gonna head into the water for a quick splash.